this one?
Yeah.
But this thing over here, we all had the backpack.
Oh, yeah.
The backpack, I don't know if you had this one, but this is an Army thing.
Well, I was Army, we were reconnaissance too, so we traveled pretty light.
Yeah, this one, this is pretty light in compared with the Marines use.
The shade on this is the 107, you can tell by 107, because they made a lot of difference now.
His name is Tony Quesada. That is a nickname for Porfirio Quesada. I served in Vietnam twice, 2.5 years, with aviation helicopters. That was my job at that time, and it was so for several years since then.
I went to Vietnam in 67, 68 with 4th ID, Alpha Company 38th. Spent 1 year in Vietnam. I was wounded in 1968. Then I left there. I came back to Fort Benning, Georgia. I was in Fort Benning, Georgia for 5.5 months. After leaving there, I went to Germany. I was at Germany, at Wildflick in Germany. And I re-enlisted in 69 to go back to Vietnam in 1970. I went to 71, I got wounded. And that was a story that kind of scared me a little bit, because I was told when I got hit that I would never walk again. But thank God that he had another plan for me.
My name is Pete Rosie. I joined the Army in 11 August 1959. And never had it so good. Three hots and a cot. Stayed in the Army 21 years. And my first tour in Vietnam, I was with the 196 Light Infantry Brigade. We went on a ship, the whole brigade did, went on a ship from Boston to Vietnam, and we were on the ship 30 days. We were glad to get off that ship when it got to South Vietnam, but as soon as we got on land, we were wishing we were back on the ship. We were right in the thick of it. And anyway, as time went by, I was a squad leader for a recon company. And we went out and scouted for the main force. But one day, we were out on patrol, and we got ambushed, and it wasn't a pretty sight. We lost three guys, and anyway, I'll never forget that. And that was my first tour. Second tour I went over, and that was in 1966 when I went over for that tour. Then I went back in 1971. 72, and it was on the second tour I got wounded. I was out on patrol, and I was in an armored vehicle, an armored personnel carrier, sitting on top, fortunately. And when we hit down a tank mine, I went flying off, and what saved my life was me sitting on top. The two fellas that was inside, the concussion killed them, and I was lucky. I was very lucky.
Conrad A. Myers, Jr., and I was assigned to the MACV, which is in Canto, Vietnam. I ended up getting my Purple Heart by crossing a river, and the tree that we were walking across twisted, and I fell into the water. And at the same time, we were being shot at, and I didn't even know that I was shot. I was concerned about the water because I can't swim. And I ended up getting out of the water with some help from my interpreter. And he said, "Hey, you've been shot." I said, "What?" And I looked at him, I said, "Okay." So since I was the medic, I bandaged myself up and I had to go by helicopter back to the main hospital.